When you process a lot of data, you also need data centers. But that much data can really make the system overheat. It takes a lot of cooling and a lot of money to pay for it. So, is there a cheaper, less energy-intensive way to keep your hot data cool? What the tech? More and more data is ending up in data centers, and more data centers are consuming more and more energy. Trends such as mobile internet, cloud computing, and networking in various walks of life are naturally fueling this. As a result, capacities are being expanded all the time. There are now around 3,000 data centers in Germany. Together, they consume more energy than the whole of Berlin. What's more, data centers still often produce a lot of CO2. Even though more and more attention is being paid to sustainability here, too. Incidentally, cooling is the area that requires the most energy in data centers. This is because electrical energy is converted by the servers, storage, and network components into computing power and, ultimately, into heat. To ensure that parts working around the clock aren't damaged or even destroyed by the heat generated, most of the cooling capacity is put into regulating the temperature of the hardware. But this is becoming increasingly difficult, as the available installation space is also becoming smaller within data centers, while the packing density, computing power, and therefore the cooling capacity required are increasing. What is needed here are ingenious fans that can generate more pressure against the high packing density and transport more air with the same diameter. And they must be fitted in a system that is as efficient as possible. This is where the data also helps in the data center. For example, temperature, speed, airflow, and operating status can be displayed and regulated in real time. This saves energy, money, and reduces CO2 emissions. And the discharged heat is ideally recycled, for example in the district heating network, to supply households with heat and hot water. So no energy is lost unnecessarily either. Would you have thought that cooling in data centers is so important? And that so much is being done to make them more and more sustainable? What are you specifically interested in? Feel free to let us know in the comments. For more and a steady stream of new videos, be sure to subscribe to the channel.